originals. I'm not going to ask. That'll kind of show your age, but I don't know how many of the originals are still here, but praise God, he's still here, and he's doing a lot of things, that's for sure. So here's what we're going to do. We're going to start out. Bob's going to lead us in a song. You got a page. I think we're going to sing 186 first, correct? We're gonna sing a song. I want to read a scripture, make a couple comments. Then I got four guys that are going to pray, and then we're going to go back inside. So let's go ahead, Bob. You go ahead and lead us in a song.
Okay, 186, the Church of One Foundation. We're going to sing the first and last verse. Ready?
The Church is one foundation, is Jesus Christ her Lord. She is his new creation by water and the Word. From heaven he came and sought her to be his holy bride. With his own blood he bought her, and for her life he died. Yet she on earth hath union with God the Three in One, and mystics sweet communion with those whose rest is won. Oh, happy ones and holy, Lord, give us grace that we, like them the meek and lowly, on high may dwell with thee.
I wanted to read one verse for you out of Hosea chapter 10, the verse is verse 12. Here's what it says. Sow to yourselves in righteousness, reap in mercy, break up your fallow ground, which is what we're about to do. For it is time to seek the Lord till he come and rain righteousness upon you. I searched in my mind about what to say here today, and when I read that verse, here's what came into my mind. How easy it is as believers to become content and say, you know what, we've got the building, we have reached this place, and we're just content to stay right here and do nothing else. And God never wants us to get to that place.
Amen.
Never, ever. And so that's why we're standing out here tonight, because we feel, we believe 100% that God is leading us toward the expansion of this building. A lot of people would say, why would you spend that kind of money? My response would be this. I would rather we spend that money on this project and the Lord comes back and we're in the middle of the project and be sitting on it and doing nothing whenever he comes back.
Amen.
And so God has provided and God will provide. I want you to pray. We've got some hiccups in the building process. Nothing to hold things up and to stop us or anything like that. But there's wrinkles that need to be ironed out before the 20th, whenever the builders are going to start. So I want you to be praying about that, if you would. So with all of that said, that's all I got to say. Joe Kennedy, would you do the honor with the gold shovel and take the first scoop of dirt out of the ground and hold that scoop of dirt? All right, let's give Joe a hand. Okay, Joe, you can put that scoop of dirt down. Whenever we go back in, there's a whole foundation right underneath here. You can get started on it. Okay, here's what I've done. I've asked Gary and Joe and Bob and Joe to pray this evening. So we might as well just start right at that end with Gary. As they come right down the line praying, when Joe's done praying, we're going to sing one more song and we're going to go back inside. So Gary, why don't you start us off with your words?
Father, we just thank you now for just another opportunity to be able to call upon you now. I know that you are there and you hear our prayers. We just thank you for the church you've blessed us with. We just thank you so much for the people here, for the pastor you've blessed us with. And now as we do dedicate this new building to you, we just thank you for how you provided the monies to pay for this, and how you provide the workers and all our each and every need. And just pray and ask that you will be with us all, that us always work together, and us always have the love and unity that we need in our church now. We But most of all, Lord Jesus, we just thank you for your love, how you made this all possible, how you suffered and bled and died on that old rugged cross for our sins. I just want to thank you again for what you're going to do in Jesus' name. Amen.
Loving Father, we thank you, Father, for this beautiful evening that you blessed us with. How we think of the words of how good it is that we dwell together in unity. We thank you, Father, for the opportunity that you've given us. We count it an opportunity and a privilege to expand this building, not for us, but for you. Father, we're reminded of the words in Haggai, go up into the mountain and get wood and build my house. Oh, Father, we pray that we think of on this very ground in which we're standing, someday will be classrooms for our children, grandchildren. Father, we pray that you would use these first for their salvation, and then that they'd be trained and nurtured in the admonition of you, that they would grow up to serve you and with every fiber of their body. Father, we thank you. We praise you for this church. Thank you for our pastor, for each one here that labors to spread the word. Father, we pray now just to bless this. As our brother prayed, thank you for providing thus far. We trust you, the God of all, that owns everything, to meet every need as we go forth. We thank you in Jesus' name. Amen.
Father, we again thank you for the grace that you extended to us and that you saw fit to raise up another local assembly here at Claysburg Bible Church. We just thank you for that and thankful that we're obedient to you. Cause us to want to be obedient to your word, and you tell us to occupy till you come. Lord, may we be faithful, and we ask your blessing upon each one.
Father, we come to you, we're so thankful, and Lord, I'm thankful that you give me this opportunity and the privilege that I can be a part of this church, be a part of the church family. We have such a great church family here, Lord, and I remember, I was just thinking today back at the little church in Claysburg, whenever I started there wasn't a lot, I can't remember how many went there, but then it got to really preaching the word, and it just got big. We had to have two services in the morning, and then I look back on that, Lord, and I see that was just you giving us the courage to walk up here in an alfalfa field and commit to you that we was going to build a church for you, and you provided everything for us, Lord. You brought all the good people in, talented people from different churches to help us, Lord. And Lord, everybody worked together. We had no problems, Lord, and we're so thankful for that. The whole thing was, Lord, nobody was hurt on the job. There was a lot of us working here. Nobody was hurt. And you're always concerned about people stealing things, Lord. There was nothing ever stolen from whenever we was working here, Lord. But we still doubted you a little bit whenever you throw the figures around $4,000 for a little community like ours. But Lord, we'll have more faith this time because we know everything comes from you, Lord, and Lord, you provide everything for us. Now as we go back into the service, hear the teaching of the word again, we have communion, let us all go home and say it was really great to be in the house of the Lord, and we give you all the praise and glory in Jesus Christ. Amen.
I think we need one more guy to take a shovel of dirt, and he's standing right here.
Oh, okay.
So we can get your picture. Yes, sir. And it's, you want a pair of gloves, yes. How about a hard hat? Just stand there and hold that till they get your pictures on.
Hey.
All right, you can dump her, buddy. Yeah. Okay. Hey, listen, you all be praying for the workers. Pray that while the workers are here, because last time we did a lot ourselves, but this time we got guys coming in. So pray that we'll be a testimony to them. We'll have an opportunity to work with them. You all may be able, I'm sure, to be able to provide some meals for them. If I can come in a day and say, hey, listen, here's what the church wants to do for you guys for a day. We're going to provide dinner for you or provide lunch for you. Great opportunity as an outreach to be able to reach out to these guys. So just keep that in mind as we go along and continue to pray.
Thing that the other, whenever we was working at the other church, I didn't mean to interrupt
you. No, go ahead.
But the food was great.
Oh, it sure was. It sure was great.
I mean, they come to work just to get the food.
Yeah.
I didn't mind working all day.
Yeah. So what's going to happen, those guys are going to roll in here, and they're planning on starting around the 20th of September. We're hoping by the 1st of November, the entire outside of the structure is built, and then we have all winter to work on the inside. We plan on working on the inside ourselves. So any of you guys that can drive a nail, any of you guys that can plug in an extension cord, we're going to plan on being on the inside working throughout the winter to get the work done there. So any of you ladies or even guys that want to provide food for the guys from the church that are here working throughout the winter, that'll be accepted too and very much appreciated. So. Okay, Bob, we're down to the last song, if you would.
Hey, the only other song you have, Blessed Be the Tie That Binds. We're going to sing verse 1 before we go back in.
Blessed be the tie that binds our hearts in Christian love. The fellowship of kindred minds is like to that above.
Before we disperse, let me pray with us. Father, we thank you for this service. I thank you for the people that are here. Lord, you've done so much. I think back at 15 years ago whenever I was voted in and where we are now. And Lord, it's not because of me, but it's all because of you. Jesus promised that he would build his church and the gates of hell would not prevail against it. We thank you for that. Lord, as we get ready to go into this project, we pray for every worker that comes here, for safety for them. You watch over them, whether they be bricklayers, blocklayers, whether they be carpenters, plumbers, whoever they are. Lord, we just pray for each and every one of them. Lord, that your protection would be on them. Put your protection all around the project. Lord, we don't have everything that's needed to build it. We don't. We know that, and so we're trusting you. So as we go along, might you work in a way that takes any temptation from us to be able to claim the victory, to know that it's all you. And as you provide, might we be quick to step up and to magnify Jesus Christ as you meet the needs when we go through this project. So Father, tonight it's been a scoop of dirt. We look forward to the day whenever it's the opening of a door to step in. And in between, Father, we'll trust you. Teach us to walk by faith, we pray. We ask this now in Jesus' name.